I need to know if I'm placing a new queen, is this a valid place to put it relative to the other queens that were replaced?
Okay, so the first computer programmers were women. And if you look at photos of IBM teams in the 1960s, it looked like the United Nations. You know, it was diverse in every imaginable way. Things started going downhill in the 1980s. When I think about why it matters, I go back to something that a colleague of mine, Bill Wolf, said probably 20 years ago, and that is that computing, software design, it's a really creative process. And everybody brings their own perspective to any creative process. And if there are segments of the population that aren't represented, you're going to get a worse solution.
Diversity isn't just important because we want to have equal opportunities for women or for their own individual achievement. We also need diversity because we're going to solve problems better. We're going to create better products and technology if everyone from all different backgrounds are at the table making contributions.
An example for us is recognizing the importance of outreach to the schools in our region, to the parents, to the teachers, to the kids.
Computer science department at the UW does a really good job of reaching out to women, and one of the ways that they do that is making the school itself approachable to people that we call interest changers, which are people like me. So when I took the first introductory programming class, I also took the women's seminar that the computer science department offers, which is just a group of women that also happen to be in the programming class. And we meet once a week and talk for maybe an hour or two about kind of role models that have existed in the history of computer science and current issues with gender diversity in computer science.
The primary purpose is really to encourage them to stick with CSE, let them know that they belong in this industry, even if they don't have previous experience, and to really build confidence so they feel prepared to major in computer science.
Discussing these kind of issues that are happening in the industry up front really gave me the chance to, you know, stay inspired and stay driven and thrive to reach my goal.
I think the importance of having role models is really important in our introductory programming courses. We have about 75 TAs that help instruct our program and meet with students and encourage them to continue on. And about half of these TAs are women.
I think I bring like a different perspective than most TAs because like I remember how terrified I was on the midterm, and I actually just like freaked out and like forgot how to code basically on the midterm. And so like I think it taught me to be like a little bit more empathetic when teaching. I think that's really important. I think definitely the fact that like I've seen more and more girls kind of reach out to me is like a really kind of, it's a really good sign. Like I'm really happy that that's happening. And so that way we've been able to kind of turn around their grades, you know, or like, you know, talk about steps and ways to improve earlier, which I think has really boosted their confidence.
Our big shortcoming here is we have done not nearly enough with economically disadvantaged students or underrepresented minorities. And we're starting to focus on that now. I think people lose track of the fact that they had a set of circumstantial advantages that they benefited from. And there are other people who are just as capable who weren't blessed with those advantages. And if you just help them along a little bit, they can be a rocket ship.